Hi, I'm Tyler, and today I'm going to talk to you guys about the difference between popular and scholarly sources. Here at Iowa State, they can be found in the general collection and the periodical room of our campus library. So, the periodical room has the most recent issues, so let's head there now. Okay, made it to the periodical room. As a business major, I would like to use business sources to show you guys the difference between a popular and a scholarly source. So let's check out this one. Okay, I got this one here, Money Magazine, and this would be a popular source because as you can see, it's very colorful and many images are included and it's glossy. These type of sources can be found in checkout lines in places such as Target and Walmart, and the language is normally very simple and easy to understand, and the articles are normally short. These type of sources are published very, very frequently, monthly and even sometimes weekly. There are normally not any references included within the issue, and the author is even sometimes unknown. The information within the articles are edited and proofread for accuracy only, and there's normally many advertisements within the issue. And for the most part, popular sources are very entertaining to read. So now that we're finished looking at popular, let's look at the scholarly sources. Okay, got this one here. Looks like it's Business Ethics Quarterly. So it looks like this would be a scholarly source. And I know this because it's not colorful at all and no pictures are included, and it seems very educational. These type of sources are written by people such as researchers, faculty, professors, and they're actually issued a lot less frequently than popular sources because they go through a peer review process. And this process entails a subject expert proofreading and editing all the information within the article. The language within the articles is very complex, and the author's credentials and references are always included. And as you can see, it's filled with text. There's no color, there's no ads. Scholarly sources are all about the research. So that's all I had about comparing scholarly and popular publications. Thank you for listening, and I hope it was helpful for you.